everyone, Christina here. Welcome to another Make a Card Monday video. Today I have a card for you that I made using some Distress Marker watercoloring. And make sure you stay until the very end because I have a quick announcement, something new I'm going to be doing on my channel, and it's a way for all of you to be involved even more in my videos. So stay till the end, and we're going to jump right into the card. I'm starting out with two stamp sets. The first one is Good Gab from Paper Smooches, and the other is Chevron Backdrops from Lawn Flan. I've used this one quite a bit, so it's kind of yellowed with the ink that I've used. But I'm going to be mounting this middle zigzag on my stamp press, as well as the Merci. You'll see what I'm doing here in a minute. Okay, first what I want to do is get my stamp on my stamp press completely straight, and I'm going to have it kind of come off the side of the stamp press. Just get on there really straight. Okay, and then I'm going to be taking the Merci, and I'll put that on my grid mat right there, and I'm going to have the Merci be right above my zigzags. Lovely. Now I have some watercolor paper here. This is Simon Says Stamp watercolor paper. It is cut to 4 inches wide by 5 1/4 tall. And I'm going to be doing some embossing. And I do want to make note that there are two sides to the watercolor paper. There's one that's more smooth. I want to be stamping on the smooth side because I want it to stamp as well as possible. And if it's a little bit too textured, some of the stamping won't come across. And I just realized that I mounted my stamp on here wrong. It was upside down. Yeah, not gonna work, Christina. Okay, so we're gonna remount this one really fast. And I'll just get that on there straight according to the Merci. Okay. All right, I'm going to be embossing. So I have my embossing magic powder bag here, making sure I'm getting the smooth side. Okay. And I'm just rubbing that along my watercolor paper. Not a ton, but you know, just enough to get going here. And I'm going to be using Versamark ink. You could also use any other colored sticky ink for this because we are going to be covering it with white embossing powder. But just for the sake of, you know, that I always use Versamark, I'm going to keep using it. So I'm going to go ahead and stamp this, and I want it really straight on the watercolor paper, and it's going to come down about right here. Lovely. All right, and I'm going to go ahead and apply the embossing powder. I'm going to be stamping that zigzag one more time above the Merci, but I want to be able to see it clearly. So I'm going to go ahead and add the embossing powder. So you can kind of see that a little bit more now. And I'll just set the embossing powder aside for a minute. All right, and I'm just going to go ahead and take this Merci off. And I'm going to need to remount this with the bottom showing because I want to make sure I have the same side. Because this stamp has a thin zigzag on one edge and a thick zigzag on the other. And I want to make sure that it lines up in the continuation there. So I'm going to ink up this bottom portion of the stamp. And now that I can see that, I can get a better idea of where it needs to go. It's super hard to see. I must have to like shade it so I can see what I'm doing here. Okay, I think that'll do it. Right there. Did get a little bit on my work surface here, but a baby wipe will clean that off. Just wipe a baby wipe right there. Now I'll let that dry while I do my embossing. All right, the Merci wasn't perfectly centered in there. You guys can see that's not perfectly centered, but it's pretty close. All right, when I emboss this, it is going to take a little bit of time to melt. So I'm going to hold my heat tool away from the project until my heat tool has completely reached its max heat, its max temperature, and then I'll apply it over to my project.
Thank you.
All right, now I'm going to be using some of the new Distress Marker colors. These are mostly the seasonal colors of the Distress inks. I'm going to go ahead and get these out. Okay, I'm going to use these colors, and probably in this order, they're a little bit of a rainbow order. And what I'm going to do is take the brush tip end. The first color I'm using is Squeeze Lemonade, and I'm just going to add a little bit of color over the top. And the white embossing will, I can pick that up on my finger here, what it does is it repels or resists all of the ink. So I'm just going to bring this down quite a ways. Then I'll move on to the green. This is Mowed Lawn. I can even overlap those just a little bit. Peacock Feathers. Salty Ocean. And then Seedless Preserve. And I'm going to go back in the other direction until I get the end of the watercolor paper. Okay, now I'm going to get my watercolor brush. And this is actually a Tim Holtz watercolor brush. And it has like a really wide brush tip. That's going to help me get all of these colors mixing and melding. So I'm just going to start going back and forth like this. And it's going to pick up those colors just like watercolors. And I'll start to mix those colors together. I want to get a little bit of those brush strokes. I really love how the Salty Ocean and the Seedless Preserves mix. I think of all the colors, my favorite is Peacock Feathers. Okay, so I have that kind of rainbow. Not really rainbow. I like to have like red and orange in there for it to be true rainbow, but sort of just like a movement of color. I'm going to take that baby wipe I used earlier, and it has one corner that's a little bit dry, and I'm going to use that just to pick up any of the color on the embossing. I'm just going to run that over and pick any of that up. That's going to really bring out the white stamping. You can still kind of see the edges of the marker, so I'm going to go over that with my paintbrush again and just kind of get that moving. Probably just needs a little bit more water to get it going. All right, I'm going to hit this with my heat tool, but I'm going to be really, really careful because I don't want it to start melting that embossing powder again. All right, I think I'm actually going to cut off this one edge here. I have some black cardstock from Basil. It's from their Card Shop collection. And I'm just going to square that at 5.5. All right, this is going to go on the card front like that. But because I don't want just big black bands on the side, I'm going to go ahead and add some embossing. I'm going to use the Swiss Dots embossing folder. That's because this zigzag pattern can be pretty overwhelming, especially if there's another pattern with it. So I'm just going to put this in my Big Shot machine and add some dots. All right, I'm going to put this on some foam adhesive. Just my usual scrapbook adhesives foam squares. All right, I'm lining this up on my board here, and you know what? I'm going to go ahead and take it to the very top and then trim off the bottom. So the card will be just slightly shorter than 5.5, it'll be 5.25. Yeah, I had to improvise a little bit. I did want it to be the whole front of the card, but I didn't like all the edges and things like that, so had to improvise just a little bit. And then I'm gonna take my corner chomper and just round these two bottom corners. And that's the card for today. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for staying till the end, you guys. I have a quick announcement. I'm going to be starting a new monthly feature on my blog. It's going to just be called Mail Call. I'm going to give you my P.O. Box address. It's down in the video description, so make sure you check that out. What I want you to do is each month I'm going to give you kind of like a theme or a topic, and you send me your cards based on that theme, and then I'll pick out a few of my favorites and show them on camera to you guys. So this is not my home address. This is a P.O. Box. I just want to make sure you guys know that. So it's just down below. Go ahead and send me mail. And this month's theme is Halloween or autumn. So anything with fall or Halloween, if anything like that, go ahead and send me your cards. I love to see what you guys are doing, and I will pick out some of my favorites and show them here next month. So thanks for watching, and I will catch you guys next time.
Welcome to the very, very end of my video. I have three additional videos for you guys to watch. The first one is my short, you know, 3 or 4 minute vlog from Los Angeles when I was visiting YouTube Space LA. So go ahead and watch that. The video in the middle is my last Make a Card Monday video, which was sadly so many weeks ago. And the very last one on the right is my very last or most recent Friday Focus video. It was the second video in my envelope series. So check those out. Also check me out on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Pinterest, and don't forget to subscribe. I will see you guys on Wednesday for another Color Wednesday. Thanks for watching.